construct minimal DFA for alphabets AB for language L, which has strings that starts with BA, substring BA. Now, let us see what is minimal DFA. Now, when I say minimal DFA, number of states in minimal DFA must be less than that in DFA. Okay, now strings possible in language L. So L is equal to BA, BAA, BAB, BAAB, etc. It goes on like this, but it should all begin with BA, substring BA. Now, construct your DFA. Construct DFA. Consider smallest string possible. Consider smallest string possible. So the smallest string is B. Now Q naught is the initial state. It accepts B as input and it moves to the state Q1. Then A as input and it accepts and moves to the next state Q2. This becomes the final state. This becomes the final state for this BA. Now after this BA, I can have BAA, BAB, etc. with any number of A's and any number of B's. So at this state, it can accept any number of A's and any number of B's. Okay. Now, check out for completeness and also for strings that should not be accepted. Now I have my structure like this. At this state, I should not accept A. If I accept A, it should come to the dead state. In the same way, all my strings should start with BA. So the first alphabet should be B and second alphabet should be A. This should not be B. So here it should not accept B. If it accepts B, it should move to the dead state. If it accepts B, it should move to the dead state. In the next, it can accept any number of A's and any number of B's. Now check this for completeness. At Q0, it goes for accepting A and B, both the inputs. At state Q1, it goes for accepting both the inputs A and B. At state Q2, it goes for accepting all the inputs A and B. So in all the states, it accepts all possible inputs. So it is a complete DFA. Check for counter string. Suppose I have a string A, B, A. Now, when I go for considering an input A, it automatically comes to the dead state. This dead state is not the final state, so this string is not accepted.